Hi, End of the Road News, Taylor Taranto, reporting. All right, today's episode is just a catch-up of what's been going on today, since the last time. And I'm going to play some more about what my living conditions are like, so I can get my therapy out. All right, Trump's shooter's parents, both licensed counselors in Pennsylvania, seeking legal counsel before public comment. Netanyahu visits D.C. in light of the Secret Service Director resigning. Harris and Patty Murray, Senator of Washington, Democrat, refuse attendance to Netanyahu's speech. Biden and press secretary disappear for a week, then return for Black Swan Song tour on The View, and then a national address for dropping out tomorrow. President Harris has until August 7th to pick her VP at the DNC. That's a weird way of interpreting the 25th. Kamala's parents weren't U.S. citizens at the time of her birth. That's a pretty big deal. Therefore, she isn't eligible to be president. That might be true, but, you know, we got to give Trump a pass, I guess, then, too. You know, we started getting this stickler, like, we have to start saying stuff. You know, they allowed Obama to run two terms, so I don't think it's that big of a deal right now. But it should be talked about, because in the beginning of our country, that was the intention, so. Okay. Biden said 4 years ago, quote, "I told Barack that if we reach some sort of fundamental disagreement, I'll develop some disease and resign." End quote. Now, some people are speculating that Biden is already dead. He may be. And they're also referring to the flags at half staff. The flags at half staff are supposedly for Sheila Jackson Lee, or Lee Jackson, or whatever her name is. That weird, sick piece of shit. Anyways, Matthew McFadden. Emmy winner joined Deadpool and Wolverine as Mr. Paradox, says he has a man crush on Ryan Reynolds and Jackman. He played Mr. Darcy in Pride and Prejudice opposite Keira Knightley. He recently acted in Operation Mincemeat with Colin Firth, who also played Mr. Darcy in the 95 BBC adaption. Now, what's his name? Ryan Reynolds and Jackman in an NFL game with Taylor Swift, and weren't even noticed. Ryan Reynolds, let's see here. Ryan Reynolds, something on Deadpool. Oh, he watched Deadpool and Wolverine with his 9-year-old son, or child, or daughter, or whatever the hell it is. And doesn't necessarily recommend you do that with your kids, but said it would be at the time of his life. Well, that's interesting. Wade Wilson's body double, or double body murder trial, reached conviction on June 12th, and sentencing was pushed back from the week of Deadpool and Wolverine movie release to a month from that to August 27th. That's pretty strange connection there. And who could have saw that coming? Anyways, one jurist is speaking out as the 87th, not to be confused with 187, code for murder. Wade Wilson will be given the death penalty. She says she has faith in the justice system, therefore everyone else should too. Originally reported by Wink News. In other news, Marine vet Zach Rell ordered to pay back $100,000 in military benefits while serving his 15-year prison sentence with Army vet Joe Biggs on seditious conspiracy charges. That's the January Sixers. Michael Moore, film producer and director of fake documentaries, is pushing Biden out so Kamala can be the incumbent and first woman president in an effort to convince Americans she has experience to boost her popularity and possibly defeat Trump. HBO's Veep ran between 2012 and 2019, which mirrors Biden's fallout and Harris's rise. The creator of the show said they were still looking on an ending, end quote. And I assure you that it's coming if you look around you and keep listening to the news, because there's lots of things going on. Republicans threatened to sue DNC to keep Biden on the ballot. Okay, guys, that's not how you win. You don't sue the DNC to keep someone else on the ballot. You know, you could have impeached him. I mean, there's all sorts of ways you could have actually got. Nikki Haley demands Haley voters for Harris to cease and desist. John Boyd said he'd tell Francis Coppola, whatever, that he's gone too far if he made his character in the likeness of Trump in Metropolis, where he supposedly directs rioters to storm the Capitol. All right, let's see what else we got. All right, congressman introduced impeachment articles against Kamala. You could have done that any other time. Now it's the least convincing because of the political ramifications of it. Three additional individuals ID'd as suspicious by police, Pennsylvania Police Commissioner. Far left, that's a shooting, by the way, for the Trump thing. And so now we have three additional individuals. They didn't tell us who they were, no one does them. So, far left protesters infiltrate House office building, and 20,000 expected to shut down Capitol tomorrow. That's interesting. There's lots of people saying, well, are they going to be treated like the January 6ers? We'll find out. Probably not. Biden-Harris. Well, wait a minute. Didn't that already happen on January 6th? So we're just going to say, well, that didn't happen. They didn't charge all those radical left. I mean, I just keep seeing them come in and out of here. Keep seeing these far left fake Trump supporters coming through here. All right, let's see here. Biden-Harris super PACs have been fighting a meme war carefully against Democrats to play make-believe that she is actually popular and can win against Trump. This isolated echo chamber slowly expanded and was recently bled over into the wild. Coconut tree memes and coconut pilled memes were instantly slaughtered by meme master warlords, by memes made well past 2020. So these are what we call fine wine memes that only get better with age. And they were so dank that Harris won't be able to walk right for weeks, just like how her political career started, walking out of her boss's office. So it will end. Getting fucked by a giant mean dick right up her cooper. All right, media started this day saying how easy it will be for her to win against Trump, and ended the day screaming at everyone for listening to their friends and family and then reading for themselves that she sucks so hard she got promoted, literally. I personally like the birther "she ain't black and her family are slave owners" memes. The media is already on defense and can only be caught saying that these are pre-debunked memes. So, you know, when you have so many people out there that are like, oh, yeah, 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 and then the media comes out and says, in her defense, the same day that they're saying, oh, she's going to be such a great president. And then you read the article and it says, oh, yeah, and this is fake, and this is fake, and this is fake, and it doesn't say any reason why or doesn't go into the argument. You better believe it's not that it's fake, it's that they can't actually defend their position. So, that's the end of the news for now. Now, some people are saying, you're not a real reporter, and I'm going to report right now about my living conditions, what it's like in here. So, well, I live in a 8 foot by 8 by 15 foot cell. It's constantly locked. I have a toilet, a sink, a really hard bed, a desk thing with a swiveling chair, and my writing supplies, my tablet that I'm talking into, a couple books from the library. They finally gave me library access, but they never give me the books I actually asked for, and they don't even try to. I'll ask for a book, and then they give me two other books that I didn't ask for that had nothing to do with the style or even theme or subject matter of what I was asking for. And then they say, well, we tried, and it's like, I don't think you did. These books aren't hard to find. You can always ask someone to find them. I mean, you can at least try. I don't have access to educational benefits. They asked me if I did want some, and I said yes, and they gave me a stupid app. My tablet doesn't have a working speaker, so I can't actually watch any of the...
You have 1 minute remaining.
These are just videos that you can find on YouTube and aren't that educational. They're more like edutainment. Some of the books on here, I mean, I've read most of them that are actually decent. The rest aren't very good. And most of them are fiction. Let's see here. I asked for mental health services, and they didn't feed me the next day, and then they teased me until a bunch of... I had to file a grievance, and they still haven't even given me mental health services. They actually fed me trash that day. That's what I was referring to the other day. They fed me people's leftovers. They just scooped it up into someone else's tray that people would put people to need and put it in the one tray and then handed it to me as if that's like kosher or something. So anyway, that's kind of like what it's like to live here. And you can...
Thank you for using Global Tel-Link.